Hello. Okay, why can I not see my screen? Let's see. Okay, there we go. We got the screen going. There we go. Hi guys, it's Shimmy. I'm just gonna silence that. Perfect. That's silenced, which is awesome. I'm gonna make that size. So today we're going to do an altered cigar box, which is so much fun. So I just have this old cigar box. It was full of paper. I paid 10 cents for it at a yard sale, as you can see. I decided to save the $2 one that I was telling you guys about for another project. But yeah, so this is it. This is the famous cigar box that I've been saving to alter. And we are going to alter it. It did have a lot of paper on, so I got as much of it as I could off. This is a pretty old box. Like, it's been around for a lot of years. So some of the paper is really stuck on there. So I'm just going to say that it adds texture. Now I am going to be working mostly on the top of it. I will paint the sides probably at another time, but I'm going to use my deco arch gesso and I'm going to go ahead and get started. I did sand this a little bit too, but it's just a really nice size cigar box. And originally it was $6.08, but it's a really nice one and it held like 20 cigars. So it has a lot of character. I really love it. So this is paper on here. So I just sanded it a little bit and it's okay. It'll add texture and it'll be fine. So I'm just going to use my Deco Arts gesso and I'm going to apply that right on top. Now, I might not get to the sides because I don't want this to be a super long live stream. I'm hoping for an hour and a half. If we have to do 2 hours, then I will probably wait till another time to finish this project off. So we're just going to do just a light little coating of our gesso, just like that. So I hope you guys are doing well. Happy Friday to everyone. Oh my gosh, it's been such a busy week for me. Yeah, but it's good. So tomorrow I teach the kids religious education. So we're going to teach them about some of the Catholic saints. So that'll be fun, especially about Saint Valentine. So I have to prepare for that later on, but I wanted to get some arting done. And yeah. It's amazing when you run a YouTube channel. There's so much work like underneath the scene or behind the scenes that people don't see. So that's kind of what this week has been about. So I'm happy to get some art done, but I have a lot of exciting things coming up. So it's great. A lot of things that I think you guys will like for the channel. It's going to be fun. So I'm just going to kind of go over it just like that. And I think maybe that I'm just going to focus on the top right now. We'll see if I have time for something else. So I'm going to dry this, but I think I'm going to just let it dry just for a second because I want to show you something else that I need to alter and kind of get started on too. And this is just a brush that I'm using. The gesso is really nice and thick, the Deco Arts one. So yeah. And this one's a little bit thicker than usual because I left the top slightly skewed. So yeah, so it got thick on me, but it's great. I will look at the comments in just 1 second. I just want to kind of get this down. Okay, perfect. And then I'll show you guys the sides the next time we get together. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to put that down on the floor. And I just want you to see, as you can still see some of the pattern coming out. You can see it has a lot of texture. The paper's kind of coming up a little bit, but that's okay. That will add texture. You know, there's nothing you can do about it if it doesn't want to come off. So it looks just like that. All righty. Let me see here. And I'm going to just make this just a little bit smaller. Oops. Hopefully, I don't do anything crazy to like mess up the video. We shall see. Okay. Hello, Patricia. Hi, Pamela. Hi, Josie. Thank you guys so much for coming. So I'm going to go ahead and just, I don't want to waste all that gesso. Okay, cool. Alrighty. So what I have here, someone sent me these in Happy Mail. They're plastic little butterflies. So, and there's a whole set of them, and they're kind of 3D. And there's a wonderful subscriber. She spoils me, and she gives me all of these wonderful things. So she gave me a set of these butterflies, lots of sets of these butterflies, actually. Here's another set. So I've been itching to use them. So I think what I'm going to do first is I'm just going to apply a little bit of gesso on them. Now I am going to collage on them, but I thought it might be nice to have, but I do want them pretty sturdy. So we're just going to kind of, and I'm just going to use one just as the focal point. So I'm going to go ahead and just brush that. And it doesn't matter if it's uneven. It really doesn't matter. Very cool. All right, just like that, just nice and messy. Oops. Okay, I see kind of a strange looking blue thing going on my screen, which is weird. Sorry, let's see if I can. Did I do something strange? Of course I did. Of course I did. Okay, let's go out and down. What is that? Okay. Hopefully you guys can see me. Okay. Perfect. Awesome. Okay. So I'm just going to put my brush in my water. All righty. And we are going to dry this off really quick, and I'm going to dry off the box so you guys talk among yourselves. Hi, Patricia. And Love Wisdom Grace. Hello, Wendy. Nice to have you. And I'm going to go ahead and dry off, talk among yourself. You might want to silence yourself. And what are you guys doing today? Hello, Helen. I forgot that it was plastic. I'm melting it a little bit. Okay, well, let's see. And the main thing is I don't want to go too crazy because I do want it to kind of lay. I guess it doesn't have to lay totally flat. I did not think about that. But I think if we get mostly all of it, it should be okay. But I want it to be flat. Okay. Well, we're going to go with it, guys. Okay. So what I have here next is some deco arts deco page paper, and it's just these really thin papers that you can get from deco arts. So I'm going to use some of that actually on here on my butterfly, and then I'm going to use some on the star. It has a bunch of different fonts on it, and the papers are a good size, so that's about the size that they are. And I'm just gonna pick a style that I want. I really like this style up here, because a little bit of it's going to show through. And then I'm going to kind of supplement that with some book page that I have here from a dictionary, a really old dictionary, too. And I just want to make this butterfly really interesting, so that's why I'm doing this step, and I just hope that I can get it to stick. I'm kind of thinking that I might need to use another one. I wonder, will it go flat for me? It's not going to go flat. Okay, so plan B. Okay, we are just going to brush this again. Sorry, guys. I didn't even think about that. Sometimes I forget how powerful my glue gun is, or my, it's not even a hot glue gun. It's just a blow dryer, but it has a lot of power, I tell you what. So we're going to just go ahead and, because I do want it to be really flat. Because knowing me, like, I'll get it stuck to something, or I'll mess it up in some way if it's not flat. So, yes. And I do want to be able to use it. Like, I want to be able to put things in it. Maybe like little ephemera or something like that. So, normally I wouldn't be so picky, but I'm just going to get a brush. And I'm just going to let this dry just for a second. Okay. Alrighty. So I guess we're going to move on to our box. We'll go back to the box, which should be dry, and we'll wait for our butterfly to dry, and we'll do that stuff next. Okay, which is mostly dry. I'm going to give it a hit it with the heat gun. And I'm going to kind of move my stencils over because I've melted stencils before with this thing. So. So now I'm going to use my decoupage glue and mat, and we're going to start putting down some of this paper. I'm just going to tear some off. And I have stencils and embellishments and just tons of stuff on the side of me that you guys can't see, but it's here, that I'm going to use too. So it's fun. Do that. And then there's like this other style. And I love using tissue paper. This isn't as soft as like white tissue paper. It has a little bit more structure to it. Okay, just like that. So I'm going to kind of randomly put pieces down that I just want to peek out. Okay, so we're going to grab another brush. Let me get my glue brushes here. Okay. Hello, Kimberly. Very cool. Alrighty. And we're going to stick it down. There we go. So what are you guys working on today? I hope it's something fun. I wonder if you had like the creative bug like I did. Oh my gosh, it's been a stressful week, so it's good to be on here with you guys creating something that I've been wanting to create for a while, so it's good. So we're gonna go ahead and brush everything just like that. Kind of seal it down, and it's just gonna peek through a little bit. And I am going to add some hauling paste on here, too. So I'm sure there'll be lots of drying. So you'll have to silence yourself a few times, but it's live. Just like that. I'm just going to kind of make sure everything's down. Alrighty. And I really like having these kinds of bits of paper, especially down when you're going to use modeling paste, because then you kind of get, you can see a little bit of the text even more than if I just covered it up with paint and rubbed it back or wiped it back. So that's why I love that. So I'm really going to concentrate on those areas with the paper, with the modeling paste. So I'm going to do another piece here. Just like that. Awesome. Oh, cool, Kimberly, you're working on canvases. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Paper flowers always make me happy. That's awesome. And I'm sure it's not messed up. Just step back from it, and I'm sure you'll find a way to fix it. Oh, cool. And a trashy junk journal. That's fun. Oh, cool. You made a 2/6-sided boxes for your sisters. Oh, cool. Oh. Well, I'm sorry about your nephew. Hopefully you'll have a good celebration. And cool. There we go. It helps to be surrounded by your family, I'm sure. There you go. And then we're going to add a little bit down here. Alrighty. And just for the sake of time, I'm going to go ahead and put the modeling paste on, then I can dry it all in one wap. There we go. Awesome. Okay. So let me grab the stencil that I think I want to use. Oh, I promised I cleaned off my table, even though you would never know that. Because it looks a mess right now, but I did. I promise. So I think I'm going to use this one, which is another DecoArts one. So pretty. That's kind of the pieces of a clock, which is nice, but I'm thinking if I want to put a little bit of lace on there too. I just don't want to have kind of a crazy drying time, but I think we're going to put some on there. My poor little scissors. They don't even cut ribbons anymore because I've abused them so much. They're not meant to cut ribbon anyway. They're paper scissors, but. Alrighty, these are a little better. Alrighty. And this is lace that someone sent me in Happy Mail. Okay, so we're going to kind of, and I'm just going to randomly put it in spots. I thought that I was going to do something like line it up on an edge, but I don't think I like that. So we're going to kind of put that down. And I don't have a plan for this box, as you can tell. I just kind of pulled out some colors that I thought maybe I wanted to use. And then I kind of went through my stash and I thought, well, what else can I use? So that's kind of what's going on here. It's very random, as you can tell. And I just had my glue brush. Did I put it back? Yes, I did. I put it back. Let's grab another one. I can grab this one. We're going to add a little bit here. So is there... I'm glad you love like a messy desk. I was watching this YouTuber. I don't even remember what her name was, but she was recommending how you make art videos. And she said, and you should clear off your desk between frame so it looks nice and neat. And I was like, oh God, she would never watch my videos. My desk is always a mess. Like I just start one project and I move on to the next one. And so I felt a little bad. So I'm glad to hear that you don't mind a messy desk that's full of stuff. And she's like, yes, and you should clean off your mat after every take. And it's true. Her videos are beautiful and her desk is really clean, which is great. But I'm kind of a messy crafter, as you guys know, so oof, what can you do? It's great, but it was funny. Hi, Donna, how are you? I'm glad to hear that your desk is chaos, too. Oh, my. It's good to know that there are similar people in this world. I just, yeah, and I don't even care. Like, I just get the itch to create and I have to do it, you know, like, no matter what my desk looks like. So I'm glad to know that I'm not alone. And I just used the same glue to put down that, what am I talking about? The lace. That stuff that I'm using. Yes, the lace. And I have a little bit of modeling paste in here, but I'm trying to think if I should. I think maybe I'll use my new one. Has a little bit of better of a texture right now. Okay, let's put the tops on this. I'm going to remind myself so I don't mess them up. Okay, that's not the top. Why isn't it going on? Well, it's not the right top. Okay, all right. So let's grab a palette knife. And we're going to grab our stencil. And I'm just going to load my brush on there and I'm going to just rub that modeling paste right over the stencil. And this is DecoArts modeling paste, which I love. They have it in black too. which maybe I should have used. That would have been cool, huh? Not in white. Interesting. Black would have been pretty. And I never use black, like gesso or anything like that. I've used it a couple times on a couple projects, but it's just not something that I go to. But I love to experiment and try new things, so I'm sure I'll use it more. But it's fun to try new things, to try new styles. Here we go. Just like that. Gonna lift it up. And look at how pretty that is. I hope you guys can see it. I think you can. And then I'm just going to put a little bit over here, too. I really like the bottom of this stencil. We're going to put it in three places, just for our eyes, kind of. And again, I'm going to put it over the paper. And it's okay if the impression isn't perfect. But we just want a little bit of interest. I wanted that texture. And let's put a little bit up here too. And then I'm going to go ahead and clean off my stencil. And I'm trying to think if there's any other kind of modeling paste that I want to add. I don't think so. I think that's maybe it. Alrighty. Okay. So we're going to dry this off, but I'm going to give my stencil a spray before I do that. And I'm going to go ahead and run that modeling paste through. And then I'll get some interesting kind of stuff on my mat.
Okay.
Alrighty, and here's my spray bottle. Okay. Let's grab... Actually, I have one here that I have been using today. Just like that. So is anyone doing anything special for Valentine's Day? Oh, cool. Alcohol removes a dry acrylic paint from your clothes. That's awesome to know. Oh my gosh. Yeah, I should totally show you my painting pants that I... You know, and they were nice pants, but they have so much paint on them that I just dedicate them now to creating. Alrighty, guys, so I'm going to give this a quick dry, so you might want to silence yourself, and you're going to move on to the next step. Okay. My large lid there that goes on here.
Okay.
Alright. And I'm going to move all this plastic out of the way. Thank you. So I'm just, this is not fully dry yet, but that's how it looks so far. So we are going to work on our butterfly now. That I just had. Here we go. Okay, and let's do some decoupage on there too. Well, it sounds like you guys are having great Valentine's Day. I was looking while I was drying. That sounds fun. Very cool. And how romantic to have a anniversary on Valentine's Day. That's pretty cool. Awesome. Just going to add a few pieces just to give our butterfly some interest. Alrighty. Go ahead and dry off this brush. And of course, I wanted to use seed beads, so I might have to run and get those. They're like 2 feet from my desk, so you might have to excuse me for a minute, but I need to dry this off first. But I want to have some beads. I want this butterfly to have some beads. There we go. And I'm debating if I want the butterfly to have modeling paste too, but I'm probably not going to do that just because it might take a little bit to dry. But I might do it. I might be a rebel. Maybe. We'll see. Let's see. Awesome. Okay. Very cool. And actually, but I can't really dry it off. Alrighty, but I do want some texture on there. So I think what I'm going to do is add some cheesecloth because that won't take so long to dry. And this is just some cheesecloth that I got from the dollar store. Super fun place. I hope you guys saw the dollar store art challenge. That was pretty fun. There was some great projects. Like, people totally blew me away with their projects. I don't even know which one was my favorite. It was amazing. I was like, wow, I wish I would have thought of that. But it's fun. It was a fun little collaboration. Very good. So we're going to go ahead and just brush that on. And that's just because I want a little bit of texture on my butterfly. And I'm not worried about the edges because I can just cut those off. And I'm just going to go ahead and use my decoupage glue. Just like that. That was my phone trying to go off. Trying to. Okay. I know I don't have any plans for Valentine's Day. I'll probably take my mom out to lunch. It'll be fun. It'll be a good time. Here we go. And I don't care if it's not down perfectly because I really want this to be textured. So that's what I'm kind of after. It's that beautiful texture that the cheesecloth gives to surfaces. So that's what I'm going to do. All right. I'm just going to kind of stick that down a little bit. And I can trim just a little bit. I'm not going to go around it really, really good. And I might have to give up on the fact that this, I'm going to probably have to dry this. Yeah. And I'm trying to rebel against that because I want it to be flat. But sometimes you have to go with how it wants to be. So I might have to, and it's plastic. Maybe if I put it on the lower setting of my blow dryer, which never occurred to me, you know. let my makeup not melt. I just do it gently. Okay, I'm gonna go grab some seed beads. Okay, you guys talk amongst yourself. So I have those, and I have these, and I have these. So let's see which ones we want to use. And while this is kind of wet, I'm going to sprinkle some on here, and then I'll probably sprinkle them again. So I want some. Okay, I made sure this was working before we started. This is just tacky glue. Because I don't think the seed beads will stay with the glue that I'm using. And then I'm going to go ahead and go on the edges and right up here. And then just randomly, I'm going to put some marks down of where I think the seed beads should go. And I'm going to grab a piece of paper. And just like with glitter, we're going to add some seed beads. Just like that. And they're not going to go everywhere. And I am going to press them down. And then I will brush over them with the decoupage glue just to protect them a little bit. I think I'm just going to use this one color. I'm liking it a lot. And I usually get these tiny seed beads from Walmart. They're super cheap. They were $1.50, but they moved up the price. So now they're like $1.65 here in the States. So take it in. Give it the shimmy shake. And actually, it is sticking with the decoupage glue. Look, not very much is coming off. I mean, I'm really kind of try to shake it though. I don't want them coming off on my project. That's kind of the way it looks. Okay. I'm going to set that little piece of paper on the floor and try not to lose all my beads. Okay. And we're going to go ahead and brush that off. And we're just going to kind of seal them in. Because I don't want them going anywhere. But I definitely want the texture of them. Very cool. Okay, I like that. And hopefully we won't lose all the iridescence, but it's cool. So let's try that on low, and then we will move on to our box and let her dry. So let me see. Do you see how much paint I have on this thing? So I'm going to see here if I can do without it melting things just for a few minutes. Thank you. Okay, guys, so we are gonna, that's what the butterfly looks like. And I'm gonna put gesso over it and we're gonna add some color and everything. So it's gonna be really cool. Alrighty, so now back to our box, which the modeling paste feels like it's pretty, pretty firm. So I think we're good on that front. Let's remove the seed beads. And we're going to apply some paint. Okay, so I think that I'm going to use shades of purple. So, and then I'm going to do like gold accents. At least that's a plan. We'll see how it goes. So what I'm going to do first though, and I'm totally going to use my fingers. Okay. There's a lid here. And I'm just going to go around the edges of some of my paper. And over the lace a little bit. And you could do this with a brush, of course, but I kind of like to use my fingers. And I just kind of want it to blend in. So you see how that blends in just a little better. And I can kind of go into a little bit of the paper too. Just going to create some interest for us. But I love this chat. It's so cool to watch you guys chat and get to know each other. How fun is that? That's the fun part. There we go. And you get to be friends from all over the world. Alrighty. And you're right. I wish there was a way that you could share on share pictures and stuff. That would be cool. That's a suggestion we'll have to give to YouTube. Make it so that you can share pictures in the chat. That would be awesome. Alrighty, just like that. And I'm trying not to be very rough because I just remembered that I do have some modeling paste on some places, so I don't want to go too crazy, but I think we got it there. Alrighty, okay. And I am going to add more paint as I go, more gesso as I go. So these are the Deco Arts. This is Dioxazine Purple. And it's really a pretty rich, rich purple. Very, very rich. I'm gonna go ahead and spread out some of that color. And then I also have a pretty metallic purple too that we're going to add. And if it gets too thick, I can spray some water and use my paper towels or baby wipes. Like, I do want some of the paper showing here, so I'm going to kind of wipe that back a little bit. Plus, see how pretty and rich it is here, and then I don't want it so rich on some spots. I want kind of a variation. And see the way that picks that up. The stenciling that I did with the modeling paste. So pretty. And I'm just kind of randomly adding this purple right now. Because I am going to add another purple. Get some of that color up a little bit. Alrighty, I think that's enough of that one. Okay, let's get out some of our metallic. Just gives a really pretty metallic color. Very, very pretty. Okay. Let's do some there. And I'm going to try to remove as much as I can off the paper because I really want that paper showing through. Just a little bit here.
a bit. It's a little wet.
Very cool. I wasn't planning to do this, but I think that I'm going to add some gold. I think it needs one more color, and I think gold's it. So I'm just going to kind of use the paint that I have, and I'm going to just rub it over the top of the stenciling with modeling paste is what I'm trying to say. There we go. Perfect. And again, we can pull back the color a little bit if we need to. Let's pull back. I'm just gonna kind of dab it off. And I don't want to use so much water because then these will get a little soft, my modeling paste. Okay. You know what I'm thinking, actually? I'm sorry, I'll be right back. I'm gonna grab what I think might be even prettier is like a burnt sienna. So this will kind of have an aged look. And I'm sorry, but sometimes you don't quite know. Or I could do the titanium buff. That's a pretty one too. Or this is pretty too, and it gives kind of a choices, guys. Let's see here. Ooh, and this is pretty. Okay. Where am I leaning? I think actually I'm going to try a little bit of the Titan buff. Give that a shake. I don't think that that's what I wanted. Okay, let's add a little bit of the burnt sienna. I think that's better. Because I do want it to have somewhat of an age look. And I am going to add some gold, but I did think that the background needed one more color. So we're going to see what magic we can work with this color. We'll see. All right. And this is raw sienna. I'm sorry, I'm saying burnt, but it's raw. Okay, let's add a little bit here. And I'm going to kind of go into the purple a little bit too. Some of those white spots that I made. Gives it kind of a pretty antique look, I think. Which I didn't even know that I wanted to do, but I think your art speaks to you sometimes, so you just kind of have to go with it, and we'll see how it turns out. You never quite know, right? Hopefully it isn't a complete disaster, but we'll see. But I like it. It's kind of what I felt like needed to happen, so. And I can go in and add more purple in if we need it. Perfect. And then I'm gonna go ahead and add in a little bit of gesso. And I'm using my fingers just because I like using my fingers. I think I can just blend things out better, but you could also use like a makeup sponge and that would work too. All right. Okay. And I'm just lifting it up to see if I like that. Which I kind of do, actually. So it's easier, I think. Let's add a little bit over here. And you can still see some of the text coming up, which is good. Alrighty. Just like that. Because this is just my first layer, I'm going to add more things on top, so there's more fun to be had. I'm just going to get rid of a little bit of that white. Alrighty. Ooh, but I kind of like it. Oops, and you see I got that area a little too wet, so now my modeling paste is coming up, but it will add texture, so no worries, right? Okay. Do I think I need purple anywhere else? I think we lost a little bit of that richness of the purple, so let's add a little bit on top of some of our lace and in spots. Let's add. I'm just going to spread it a little bit because the fluid acrylics are so saturated and they have so much color that you can really go a long way with it. And I just keep adding stuff until it makes me happy. Actually, I like that. And it's very, you know, it's different than what I normally do, but I do like it. So the butterfly will go there. Okay, but we're not done yet. We're still going to work on our background a little bit. So I have some more stencils, but I'm going to give this a dry first. Put my tacky glue upside down. Alrighty. Let's go ahead and guys for the encouragement. I like it too. Sometimes you just have to get used to things. There we go. So I think we are going to use some of the Deco Arts metallic lustres. Hopefully I didn't get them too warm. Okay, cool. All right. And I have this stencil, which is really pretty. And I'm going to go ahead and grab another palette knife. Okay, and this is great because you can wet it and use it, or you can paint with it, you can add water to it, or you can just rub it on. So for this one, I'm going to actually stencil with it because I love the texture that it creates. So we're going to go, and you guys have seen me do this before, so I'm going to go ahead and stencil with it, and the impression doesn't have to be perfect. And this stencil is another one of Deco Art stencils. And I will link it below once this video finishes processing. And I am using the Gold Rush Metallic Luster. How are we doing on time? Yeah, it took me an hour, so this is at least going to be a 2-hour project is what I'm thinking. So we'll see. It might be a part two. We'll have to see how it goes here. But look at how pretty that is. Isn't that gorgeous? I love it. So pretty. What a fun technique. Alrighty. kind of want one. Do I want another one? Ooh, I think we'll do one up that way too. I'm just gonna turn this around. And I forgot that that was there, so I put my finger in it. But it's okay. It's not the end of the world, right? Okay, we're gonna do that here, just like so. And I'm gonna attempt to kind of line them up, but I really don't care if they aren't. I'm gonna go ahead and go in. I'm just holding my stencil pretty taut, very tight, very snug onto my project. And I'm gonna go ahead and just scrape the back. Just like that. Ooh, pretty, pretty. Okay. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Okay. Let's see if I can scrape some of this off. Actually, I wonder if we can just... No, I thought maybe we could stamp with it, but no such luck. But what I can do is I can scrape it off a bit and add it. Because I still have some on that I can fill it. Very good. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and, sorry, moving the camera. Camera's moving. And I'm going to take some out of my palette knife and we're going to go ahead and rub it. Right on top of some places. Okay, just like that. And I'm going to put the top on the gesso, which I forgot. Right? Okay. Okay. And then I did get my purple metallic luster too. Okay, so. Put that there. And then I'm thinking of another stencil that I want to use. I think maybe this one. And I think we're going to scrape it just like we did with the other one. Let me open that up. I grab a purple. I'll grab my purple. What did I do with it? There it is. Okay. Okay, we're gonna do the same thing, okay? But I better dry this. So we're gonna dry first. This off on a baby wipe and I will find something to do with this because of that beautiful color. Already? And you know what? I'm thinking that this one would be really pretty. Yeah, we'll use this stencil. And we can add the other one if we want to, but I really love this one. It's so pretty. And I'm gonna add it quite randomly. And I'm using the metallic luster. This is in Majestic Purple. They have great names for these lusters. It's so funny. Look at how pretty that is. Isn't that gorgeous? So we have that. Where else do I want to put it? Maybe down here at the bottom. And we'll do under spot. Pretty, but I just want to create that gorgeous texture. I think I want to make this a pretty textural piece. So that's why we're doing texture. That's a beautiful texture. Just like that. So pretty. Okay, I love that. Okay. Alrighty. Let's remove that. We're gonna do the same thing. So I'm gonna see if I can get any of that luster off. Very good. Not very much. Okay. Alrighty. And before I dry that off, I'm gonna go ahead and add a little bit of this on top of my stenciling, the metallic luster. Sorry I'm not looking at the chat, guys, but I hope you guys are doing good. Hopefully you're having fun. Good. There we go. A little bit down here. And I just want to bring up some of those patterns that I created. I can add a little bit on the lace too, just to bring it up a bit. Just like that. And let's add some of our purple, because I think it desperately needs a little bit of purple. Very good. And I'm just kind of worried about the texture that I created first. Go ahead and rub it through, just like that. And we're gonna go over a little bit. That's pretty. Okay. And then I am going to do a little bit of stenciling too. That way I can dry everything all at once. So I'm gonna use this stencil, which is one of my favorites, the pixelated. And I'm gonna use that with some gold paint. So I have my gold paint there, and I'm gonna grab a makeup sponge. Fun. Okay. And we're just gonna randomly put it in certain places. And you see I have too much paint on here, so I'm gonna dab it off. Okay. So the spaces where there's no texture, I am going to add a little bit of this gold. And can you see that? Isn't that pretty? Cool. We're gonna do the same thing here. So Donna, are you doing a live stream this week, or did you do one? I'm sorry, I've been so busy this week. I haven't gotten to watch anything, really. I got to catch up on a few YouTube channels, which was fun today, but it's only for a little while. No, that did not. I think I need some more paint on here. Let's try this again. Perfect. And I'm just adding just that little bit of background on the project. And I want more stenciling, so I'm gonna add a little bit more gold paint. This is Deco Arts Metallic Gold. Alrighty, so we're gonna do the same thing here. Anywhere else? I think we could use some right here. Anywhere else? I think right here. Okay. So I actually love this a little bit. I'm falling in love with it as we go. Let's see here. It doesn't really show up on the sienna, but it does show up beautifully on the purple. So I'm just really being very random when I put this down. Okay. Okay, cool. I think we're good there. I'm going to stop there. Okay. And we're going to hit dry this off just for a second, and then we're going to do some stamping. Now we are going to do some stamping. So this is a stamp that I like to use a lot. I think it's Bow Bunny. I forget what it's called, but I got it from my local scrapbooking store. It's like $2 and something cents, which I love. So I'm just going to, and I love the ones that aren't mounted. You can do a lot with them. So we're going to go ahead and just add some stenciling and some stamping. And I'm being quite random where I want to put it. Alrighty. Let's do a little bit more. And this is archival ink, in case you were wondering. And again, we're just adding texture. We're just adding more layers. Oh, I understand, Pamela. No worries. You can watch it later. It'll be on the replay. And thank you so much for coming to my live show. I just jumped on here. I gave you no preparation. Cool. Good night. Okay. Alrighty. Okay, so I think what we're going to do is we are going to paint these edges, and I'm actually going to use a paintbrush, if you can believe it or not. I'm being a rebel. Let's see here. And I just want to kind of clean up those edges a little bit with the gold paint. You can also use the metallic luster, but we're going to do gold paint. So pretty. Awesome. So I think I'm going to New Orleans. My mom, she works for the government, so they're sending her to New Orleans, so she's going to have a double bed, so I'm going to pay for my ticket there. It's going to be so fun, so I'm super excited. It'll only be a three-day trip, but it's going to be so fun. I've never been, so I'm super excited about that. I get a little bit of a travel, and then in the summer, I'm going to go on vacation, too, to Steamboat in August, so that'll be fun. That's something to look forward to. And get to see my very, very best friend, Diane, which is awesome. And she lives in Steamboat with her husband. So I'm super excited about that. It's amazing how much snow they have, because Denver is kind of in a valley. I live in Colorado, and Aurora. So we don't get as much snow as the mountain towns. But it's crazy. Like, they had to buy a snowblower because there's so much snow. So it's so funny. They'll post pictures of like all the snow up there and her husband's blowing the snow. It's so funny. He has like the snowblower out because there's so much snow up there. But boy, it's pretty. It's so beautiful up there. And lots of nice people. very, very nice people, which is fun. And she had her wedding in Steamboat, and it was so pretty. They have a gondola, you know, for the skiers. But they got married at the top of the gondola. There's this beautiful kind of, I don't know if it's a hotel. I can't remember now. It's been many, many years, but they had the reception like in this banquet room or this ballroom. It was so pretty. Prettiest wedding ever. Okay, guys, so I love the way that this looks right now. It's really pretty. Okay, so now let's work on our butterfly a little bit. Let's see what magic we can do with her. So I'm trying to think here. What do I want to do with the butterfly? Might be pretty because I really don't have as much gold as I thought that I would. So I think what I'm going to do is do a lot of gold. Let me go ahead and put this on here. But you know what? Before I do this, oh no, maybe not. Okay, we'll do this first. I'm thinking of ideas as I go. So I'm just going to paint this with gold. So I just have a little brush here that gets into all those nooks and crannies. And then what we'll do is we will brush on, and I'm trying to avoid some of the beads because I really want that iridescent color that they have. But isn't that pretty so far? I love it. Okay. So pretty. So thank you guys for helping me get my mojo back because it was gone. Wow, it's funny. I hear something about, oh yeah, thank you, Patricia. I know the food's going to be awesome. I can't wait to have bananas, Foster. I've been waiting for a long time. Oh my gosh. Lots of great food, I heard. Yum, yum. I'm super excited. It'll be fun, fun, fun. And of course, I have to check out the craft spots. So I'll be looking that up in a couple days, I think, and seeing what kind of art stores and craft stores they have there. I have to bring a little suitcase to put all my goodies in there. And probably museums too. I love to go to museums. When you go to another city, it's just amazing how much the art varies, you know? You find a whole different kind of inspiration, so that'll be fun. I'm excited. It'll be good. Very cool. Awesome. Alrighty, so I really love the way that that looks. That's pretty, huh? So, now we're going to add some of this iridescent medium, and it goes on clear, but it adds like a purple kind of sheen. I should have did that with the brush too, because I really don't want it on top of my beads, but we are going to brush some of the beads with the purple, so just to put our story together a little better, our color story. Isn't that pretty? So I like it. Okay. I think maybe let's add just a touch of pink purple. I might actually grab the same brush that I was using. Let's use this wet. I have my little net here. Add a little bit of water. There's actually this Thai restaurant. Isn't that crazy? I love Thai food. But they make the most delicious. It's a Thai style bananas Foster. I love it. I get it every time we go. I don't even like order desserts at restaurants, but it's so delicious. that I get it almost every time we come. But of course, they're not making it anymore because they're getting super busy, so they don't have time to make it anymore. But it's delicious. So they use like the Thai bananas, and then they saute them in this delicious like orange liqueur. It's so good. And lots of brown sugar. And then they make that into a sauce, of course. And then they serve it over this delicious, like, it has to be, oh my gosh, like butter cake. That's exactly what it tastes like. It tastes like it's just butter. Like, it's such a rich, delicious cake. And then on top of that, they serve their homemade coconut ice cream. It is so delicious. Oh my gosh. It's like my favorite dessert. So, and they, and the lady who owns the Thai place, she said she got the recipe because she worked in New Orleans. So that's where she got the inspiration. And of course she changed it a little bit because it's a Thai restaurant. So they use those beautiful Thai bananas. Oh, it's so good. I love that stuff. It's like yummy, yummy, yummy. Goodness. Okay. I even love that more. And you can see a little bit of the writing peeking out. I don't know if you guys can see it, but I can. We might have to turn on the light, guys. We're losing some light, aren't we? Okay. I'm going to just stick that in there and add that color right to my... Oops, sorry. I'm moving my camera around. So I'm so excited for that. I'm sorry, I don't mean to make you hungry. Oh, a medium? Oh, yes, it's just like, oh, it's this. It's called Interference, and it's Deco Arts Media Fluid Acrylic. It's a part of their collection, and what it does is it adds like an iridescence to it. So like if you're doing a canvas and you put this on, if you hold it right, it just kind of catches the light really beautifully. But it doesn't really add a lot of color. It's really pretty though. I've used it on a couple canvases. That's a great question. Sorry, I should have explained that. Like, what are you talking about, lady? We don't know what you're saying. Okay, so now we're gonna get to the fun part. All of this was fun. This is my real fun part. Look at my hands. And we're gonna start embellishing this baby. And what I was kind of like, oh, I should do, but then I didn't know if I wanted to do was, I think I'm going to add some cheesecloth. I'm just into texture right now, so. But then that requires another step. So I wonder if, but it does need something because it just kind of blends in. So I think we do need to do something to make it stick out a little bit more. But I don't think I like the shape of that cheesecloth. And there are ways, I mean, I could probably, you know, etch it in black or something just to make it stand out a little bit more. I could do that too. Let's see. We'll see. We'll see what's going on. But I really want to start. I really want to incorporate that into it. I don't know why, but I like the cheesecloth. So I think that's what we're going to use, but we're going to kind of, so more drying time. Sorry, guys. More drying time, but we're going to figure this out, I promise. All right, let's use this one. Yeah, you are totally right, Rose. It does need to stand out. I'm glad I'm not the only one because I'm like, it's pretty, but it just kind of blends in because I use the same kind of color. So, well, that's what happens. It does. And we might need to add a little bit of black to the butterfly, and that might help too. But we're going to add the cheesecloth first. Pick a piece, any piece, piece. And I go ahead and just brush it down. And then I think that I'm going to make the cheesecloth black because I think that'll go beautifully. And yeah, and then you have that pretty purple and gold and the raw sienna. And then we will have that pop of the black in the purple, mostly black though. We'll just add a little purple and gold. And I think that'll be really pretty. And you see, I covered up some of my beautiful texture, but that's what happens in mixed media, right? Unfortunately, did you cover things up? Yeah. That already looks a lot better, and it will look more better once we, more better. It will look even better when we add the black to it too. Okay. All right. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and dry that off. Sorry, Donna, you saw a gold lady? Oh, yes. Cool. Alrighty. Well, I wish, yeah, darn. It's beautiful when you can see things. I'm not the best at that. And I'm just going to add this a little bit to see if it's enough, but I can already tell that it's not. This is kind of like a smoky black. I think we need kind of a deeper black, a darker black, I should say. Very good. And sometimes things just need an extra color. I wasn't planning on using black, but really want that to stand out. So we're going to use, and you're right, I could have put some cardboard, and that would have been cool too, to have it stick up a little bit. Let's see here. But I really wanted to use the cheesecloth. So we're going to go ahead and use the black. This is carbon black. And again, it's the Deco Arts one. And I don't want to get rid of all the white, but I do want to get rid of a lot of it. And we do have a little bit of the black in the background from the stamping, so we'll see. We'll see how this turns out.
this like that. Alright, let's incorporate a little bit more of that black from the luster. Oops. It does stick out, but I don't know if I like the black. We have to figure out something to do with that black. Let's see. I think it's a little too harsh. Let's see here. Let's add a little bit of the gold. But I do want the contrast, but I might have to find it in another way. I don't like all the black. I thought I would like the black, but I don't really like it. Maybe if I go around the butterfly with the black, I'll like it. Let's add some of that really dark purple. I'm just going to keep working it until I get what I want. It will happen. I promise. And what I could also do is just go ahead and do a little bit of white on top of here too, or a little bit of the gesso, but it does stand out more to me. It does, it's standing out a little bit more. Alrighty, let's trim up our butterfly. But I love these plastic butterflies. You can use them in a lot of projects, and I have a couple more coming up that you guys will see. Stenciling though, because that took hard work. But what I can do, and this is a Deco Arts Traditional in opaque white, kind of have the placement down here. What I'm going to do because I really just want that butterfly to stand out, so we're going to go ahead and go in, and I should have dried it, of course. Yeah, that looks better. So I'm going to dry it really quick. So we're going to go ahead and put that on. Okay. But kind of where my butterfly is, I'm going to kind of go around.
get there. I promise. But this is kind of what I go through when I'm developing a project. So, all right. But you just keep working it. It will work itself out. And you'll love it at the end, but just have to keep working it. All right. Yep. And I already like that better. And then I can go around and fiddle with it a little bit more too. Yes, okay, what did I just do with the white? I just had it. There it is. I wish I had seen the Golden Lady like you did, Donna. That would have been great. Okay. I see better. Okay. But we're gonna do something else too, just to help our butterfly a bit. And then, if this works, I can just bring back in my purples, but we shall see. We're just going to go around the edges with paint. You could also do this with ink too, but I'm going to use this gorgeous paint. I can't get every nook and cranny, but I can if I go around with a brush, so I might switch over to a brush, but just so that we have kind of the hint of an outline. So I will get it, I'll get it figured out here. And it's okay if a little black gets on my butterfly. That does make it stand out more. Okay, I think we're gonna do a little bit more of that. So I just have a brush here. I'm gonna go right in. And I'm gonna make that line really heavy. And I should have done maybe a contrasting color with the purple, but I thought maybe it would stand out more. But that's okay, I like it. Just gave myself a little bit extra work, but that's okay. Sometimes you don't know until you start a project. That's gonna be. There we go. We'll just trim that off and go in. And I can even introduce some of the black in to the butterfly too, which I'm gonna do a little bit. Add a little bit out. Oops, adding too much, of course. You can't see my mat, but I did. Okay, let's add a little bit. Or a lot of it, I should say.
It's a lot of it. Okay. So I'm just using my brush and adding a little bit of interest in some places. And I can pick up a little bit of that texture that I have on my butterfly too with the black. Okay, that looks much better, but now I don't like the white. So we're gonna go in with the black. Oops, too much. Oops, okay. Too bad I didn't think of that before, of outlining it in black. But then it kind of happens. Let's see, we will get it going, I promise. Okay. Oh yeah, I like that better now. It's a little dark, but that's okay. I don't really do dark, so it's a good change. Alrighty. Okay, so let's dry this off a little bit, and I'm gonna work in a little bit of cigar. I'm just going to keep adding layers until I get what I want. All right. Okay. Perfect. Okay. So we're going to move this along, I promise. You guys have watched me fiddle with this for a really long time. I'm sorry about that. But sometimes you just have to get things the way you want them. Let's see here. What did I do with the purple metallic luster? Just add it. What did I do with it? What did I do with it? Okay, there we go. Right in front of my face here. And since I introduced some black, I am gonna add just a little bit to my background. Not very much, but just a tad in some places. Even though I have a little bit from the stamping, so I don't have to go crazy, but I just wanna reinforce that black that I added to the piece. So I'm just picking up some random spots. Okay. And I'm gonna commit. And we're gonna go ahead and put our butterfly down. And I like it. All right. Okay. So let's grab our tacky glue, tacky glue, which I just had. I put it backwards, so it would be good. And I think the sides I'll paint gold, but as I said, I will do that off camera, so you guys don't have to see that part. There we go, and of course it fell down. Should be good. I'm gonna have to open it a bit. This is a little bottle that my friend Pam gave me. It's kind of on its last leg. And again, this is just a layer. We're gonna add some embellishments and some other stuff too. But I'm just gonna go ahead and apply the glue here. Okay. But I thought about an element that I wanted to add, which I have in my little bucket. And sometimes I just like putting stuff in my little bucket that I think I'm going to use. So that's what I have here. And these I got from China. They're little metal pieces. I think I'm going to use them underneath the butterfly, like that. It's pretty, and I can dye them. Okay, and then I am going to add a little bit of metallic thread too. And this is another purchase that I got from on eBay from China. We're gonna go ahead and trim that off. And I'm just gonna kind of swirl it around my fingers here. And I can take my tacky glue. And I'm just going to kind of put it in two places. Thread can be a little fussy to work with, but yes. But I just want the texture of the thread. Okay. Perfect, perfect, perfect. All right. And then I'm going to glue these down. And really, I should just use one, so I'm not wasting another one. And I just go ahead and take my scissors. These are so thin, you can usually just chop them off with your scissors. Very good. And we're going to put one there. And one down here. Okay, and I think I should have moved up my thread a little bit. Okay, that's all right. This is tacky glue, so it's going to dry clear, so it's okay if you get it all over the place like me. Okay, and we're just going to set this right on top. Alrighty, and then you want to weigh this down with a book or something that you have. Very good. And I think I'm going to go ahead and turn on my light here. Or maybe that's, I think that's too much light. Okay. Just like that. Okay. Alrighty. And we have some stray threads, but that's okay. I want it to kind of come out a little bit, so that's fine. All right, let's see what other goodies we have in here. And I do have these metal butterflies that I thought might be pretty. Maybe we can put like one here. I think I got two out, didn't I? No. Because the rules of three, but I don't know if I like that. We'll see. We're just going to put it on there and we'll see what we like and what we'll take, get rid of. And we can put those there. But you see that my metals are kind of have the same theme. So that's what I thought here. And I should have got four corners. I never get enough corners. There we go. Stick that there, I think. Perfect. And then I do have some of this gold trim, and I think I'm going to get rid of these butterflies. Okay. And that might look really pretty on the edges. So I must decide. But I do have these too, and these I got from Tuesday Mornings in their metal little stickers that you can use as embellishments. And they were on sale. Most of everything that I get is on sale. Let's see, I'm on budget for sure. Okay, take this. Those are pretty. Maybe I'll frame the butterfly. I actually like that idea better. And let that be my, that's pretty. Okay. And I don't want to go too crazy, but I do want to make this look really pretty and ornate. So we're gonna go ahead and go through Oh no, they're from what am I talking? They're from eBay. There's a couple sellers on there, and they sell them, the little Mel embellishments, and they're called, I forget what they're called, but I can put a link. Once this is uploaded, I'll put a link in the description. But they're great. They come in butterflies, and they even have like little round pieces too that look like this. And I mean, you can get all of your little charms from there too. Like I order keys and I mean, just tons of stuff from eBay. And it does take a little while to get to you, but I've never had them not send it to me. It's insured. I usually pay through my PayPal, so I'm never really worried about that. Yeah, so it's cool. And they have some really wonderful embellishments. So I kind of like that there. Oh, yes, we're going to put that there. This is my favorite part, is the embellishing. Wow, because it just kind of brings everything together, doesn't it? Dun, 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 dun. And as I said, this is dark for me, but it's good to try different styles. And I love purple and I love gold, so I really do. Those are probably my two favorite colors, so it's not that big of a stretch. So we're going to just take these and stick them on there. Again, I'm using tacky glue. You could use glossy accents, but tacky glue usually does the job for me. And I don't use my hot glue gun just because I had a bad experience with it. But now I'm wondering how close I want these to be. Should I bring them down a little more? Oops. I think I have a sticky spot there. Yeah, I think they should be closer to the butterfly. Yeah, because then that butterfly really stands out. But there's a lot of different glues that you can use. They even have metal embellishment glue that you can use. And I think these were like on clearance for 50 cents, these little metal pieces that I'm using here. So nothing fancy. And the box was 10 cents, as you guys saw, if you were watching the beginning of the broadcast. So this is a really affordable project. The most expensive things were the paints and the lusters and that kind of stuff. There we go. Oh, that's pretty. I like it a lot so far, guys. Okay. And you know what? I'm going to go around the edges. Sorry, I don't know if you can see. I don't think you can. But on the edge, I was trying out this trim. So I think that's what we're going to do. All right. Let me move this stuff back. So you can see, I don't know why my camera is like totally funny, but that's okay. Seems like it moved up a little bit. I think because I moved it. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and just add a little bit of trim on the edges. And this is trim from the dollar store that I got. You can hardly find it. So when I do, I usually buy two quantities of it. And this is, and we're at the finishing part of our project. And then off camera, I will paint it so you guys can see how it turns out. And I'll show it in the next live show that we do. It's pretty cool. I like it. It is a live rose. Oh, yes. Really? I did not try the, I looked on the AliExpress. Is that what it's called? And I can never find embellishments there. But I mean, I pay like, I mean, you have to watch, of course. Sometimes they try to charge you a lot. But if you wait, I usually find them at a good price. So I think for like, And I think they're fenugreek is what they're called, or yeah, something like that. They're usually used for jewelry makers. These were $1 and I got a pack of 25. So, I mean, I don't think they're too expensive. I don't know, maybe it varies from country to country or something. And then the shipping is usually free and it just takes forever for them to get there. But, and the butterflies, the little mental butterflies that I got 50 of those and I paid $2 for them. So I think you just have to watch and kind of compare and see what you can find. There we go. Hopefully that's long enough. I've been known to mistrim. Oh, this is, I really like this. And this is my first cigar box. Thank you guys. Because someone sent me a message on Facebook and they were like, hey, can you do a cigar box? I totally, like, they asked me like 3 months ago. Sorry about that. But I finally got to it. And this is so fun. I love it. So thank you for your suggestions. Very good. Alrighty. And you could definitely make this more 3D. Like I said, I'm going to actually use this to put things in. So that's the only reason why I didn't do it that way. But you could absolutely do it that way. All right. And I have a few more things in here that I might use and I might not. See, I did have. And these I got from eBay too. They're $1.29. But I will put the links to all of the sellers that I get these little things from, these little embellishments. But I don't think they go, actually. I don't really like them. But it's kind of good to pull things out and see what you think. But you know what I am going to do is I have these. And I'm going to do it right in half, or in half as I can get. Alrighty. Do you see what I'm going here? I'm going to put them on the edge. And I can wipe away some of that glue. Are you guys over gluers? Because I am. I totally am. Yes, AliExpress is the name of it. And I did. I ordered a lot of washi tapes from them, but I didn't look at the embellishments. So they probably do have really nice embellishments that are affordable. I just never looked. Ooh, you know what? And I don't know if I like that there. I think it needs to be higher. What do you guys think? I think it needs to be centered with the butterfly. Yes, it does. So we're going to remove that. And I'm going to get a baby wipe. We're coming to the end, guys, I promise. And it did take 2 hours. I thought this was like a 2-hour project, even though I haven't even gotten to the bottom part, but I'm just gonna paint that very simply, I think. So let's see. Rose is right. Cut once, yeah, measure once, cut, yeah. Oh my gosh. Measure once, cut, yeah. Sorry, I can't think of what's going on right now, but that's a good, that is a good suggestion that I should use more often. Okay. Alrighty. Are those even? Do I really care? Not really. It's my box. So no. We're gonna just stick it on there. Wow. This is really cool. I was worried, guys, for a little while. I said, oh my gosh, what the heck is going on with this box? Especially when we had to put the butterfly on, but it's working out and I love it. I'm a little bit in love with the little box that I have. And I suppose I could actually measure it. Yes. So that it's somewhat straight here. So I think if I do that halfway, that's about my spot. But it's probably not going to be even anyway. But a girl can dream. Alrighty. Ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch. So I have a whole bunch of things that I want to try for the new year, in this new year. I want to try fused glass. There was this lady at a craft show, and she had the most beautiful creations. And she did. She has her own kennel, but we have a glass factory here, so I'm going to take a class. She said that that's how she learned. So hopefully the class is not too expensive. Yeah, but I would love to learn that technique. Isn't that fun? Ooh, I like it. I like it. So see, those components go together. Very pretty. Oh my gosh, I love it. Okay. Now I'm debating if I want to put some more trim on the edges, which I think I do. Like, it looks very ornate, so I think I'm just going to kind of go with that theme. And I keep promising you guys that we're going to be done, but then I just keep working. Oh, the things you put on. Oh, is $5? $14 for 100 pieces. Oh my gosh. Oh, that is a great resolution. I love that, Rose, instead of, yeah, because we can use the things that we have in a new way. That's a wonderful one. I should do that too. And it's great. Like, I went to, after our class, of course, we found out that Michael's had a 60% off coupon. And like the first time in a long time, I was not able to find anything in Michael's. And I was so proud of myself. I just walked out of there with some air dry clay that I need to make my clay hearts that I sell at craft shows and a key. And that was it. You know, and I was like, ooh. And I looked around for a really good time, but I just couldn't justify buying anything. You know, it was like, well, okay, but I don't really need that. It's really cool, but I don't need it. So I think I'm learning a little bit of restraint. Plus, I have really cool things that I need to use, you know. Get into that zone where you're just buying and buying and buying. And I think it's a way for you not to create. So at least for me. So. Yeah, so it's fun. I'm sorry you can't see me again, but I'm gluing the trim on the edges here. So I think that that is a fabulous New Year's resolution. Very, very good. And I could have done actually the outer edge, but I didn't think about that. So we're going to go ahead and turn it around so you guys can actually see what the heck I'm doing. What a concept, right? And we're going to go ahead and go like that. Sorry, and that is my phone. And we're actually going to check that because it's a weird number. Did you guys hear about this scam now that people are doing? Like, they're calling you and asking you, can you hear me? And then they record your voice and they can access like your account information. Yeah, so I'm no longer answering to strange numbers. Yeah. It's like, oh my gosh, it seems like, you know, you get on top of things and then someone comes up with a new scam to take people's money. So crazy. Alrighty. So just be careful when you answer the phone to foreign calls because they record it and then they can like get credit cards in your name. And I don't know, they have some special thing, some special way that they get your information and misuse it. Which is so sad. We have to be so careful these days. And I just had to fight a case of identity theft on my credit report. It was horrible. Like, this person, whoever they were, they ran up like $1,000 at First Bank in my name. It was horrible. And they found them like on camera and it was just a mess. So First Bank called me and they're like, oh, you owe us $1,000. And I'm like, well, no, because I've never had an account with you. So it's just crazy, but it's just a mess and it's very time consuming. And then I had to like argue with them, which is not fun. And I'm like, I'm telling you the truth. So, yeah. So I totally froze my credit. I don't have credit cards or anything anyway, so it's fine. I learned that lesson after I had to pay off the first one. And it was like a $300, I think, card when I was 18, of course. And I used it like a dummy because I didn't understand how credit cards worked, you know? And yeah. And I paid that off. And that was the last time that I ever got a credit card again. So, and it ended up being like 2 times the amount of the stuff that I bought. I was like, okay. This seemed like a good idea, but did I really need that stuff that I bought? You know? Oh, yeah. But they know to send it to 18-year-olds that don't think very well. So, yeah. Yeah, so I'm just overly, yeah, careful when it comes to stuff like that. I just wanted to share that with you guys. So be careful. Okay, there we go. Alrighty. And you know what? I think that she might be done. I'm calling her done, I think. I'm trying to think if there's anything else. And if I keep looking, I will totally find other things. Cool. Alrighty. I think that I want to put few of those jewels right at the top. And it's just fun to kind of reuse elements. I like to do that a lot. So we're going to go ahead and add that. And I think that will be my finishing touch, but who knows? Oh my gosh, you guys are like, Shami, this is the longest dream that you've ever did. Sorry, I try to keep them to an hour, but sometimes stuff happens. And I will definitely put those links on as soon as this video starts processing. I'll put it up for you guys. Because it's fun to use little metal embellishments that aren't an arm and a leg. So, yeah. And I do. I get all my little jewels and stuff from eBay, too. And the flowers are super cheap. They're not bad. I've never looked on AliExpress. I'll have to start using them, maybe. A little bit more. I just kind of love the convenience of eBay, so I do look there first. I tend to look there first. Let's add one there. And this kind of reminds me of kind of a Moroccan kind of thing. So I'm really loving it. It's very pretty and ornate. Okay. Just trying to think. And I have these other two, but I don't think those would work very well. Yeah, they're kind of a different shape. So we won't use that. And then the last thing, I promise, and then I'm totally going to let you guys go. Oh, cool. That's awesome. Malika, I pray that I'm saying your name right. Once upon a time. I think I'm going to put that somewhere on here. Ooh, yes, I like that. Don't want to put it. No, I think it looks good down there. Maybe up there. No, I'm thinking here. Alrighty, guys. And I think that we are done. I'm going to glue that down. Oops. And off camera, I'm going to paint it after it dries a little bit. Oh, that is so cool, though, that your husband does do crafts. That helps a lot. Much more understanding. There we go. Just stick that on there. Alrighty. Once upon a time. Okay. Alrighty, guys, so I'm going to bring it up nice and close so you can see it has lots of texture. And I do love my butterfly. Oh, it took you. She was a lot to wrestle with, I tell you what, but I do love it. And I will seal this whole thing with a sealer. But I just want you to see the texture. And this is the texture from the metallic luster right there. And I ran that through a stencil. And it's just really pretty. I love all the colors and all the beautiful texture, especially from the cheesecloth. So pretty. And I wish I would have figured out before that I could have just outlined the butterfly and that would have worked better. But because then I covered up all my pretty background, but that's okay. It's all right. I'll get over it. And I'm just trying to think if there's anything else. I think it's really pretty, actually. I like it. I do wish, though, that I could bring up a little bit, okay, of the, I want to add a little bit of the gold back into some of the stenciling. Just a little bit. Okay, and now I do have to let you go because I have to make dinner. Otherwise, I'm going to have some angry people, so. Very cool, but it's been so fun. There we go. That is really pretty. I love it. I'm gonna add just a little bit. And these are great. You can use them on metal, the metallic lusters. So I'm just gonna add a little bit of the brandish brass is what this is called. Let's add a little bit to our components too. Just a little bit. Okay, guys, so we're done now. Oh my gosh, okay. That was a long project, but thank you so much for joining me. And you guys should give me suggestions for what you want to see next time. Bye, Rose. You guys had some great conversation going on. Can you do that next time? There is a cigar waiting for you. Oh, cool. Yes, I would love to do another cigar. Oh, thank you, Helen. I'm so glad that you like it. That means so much. So what do you guys want to do next time? I'm going to try to do it next Thursday or Friday. Any ideas? Good night, Marianne. Oh, thank you, Christina. I'm glad you like it. I'm so happy. Any ideas that you guys want to see? I'll give you a second. I think there's like a, yeah. Anything, 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 anything. I know I have a couple ideas. I might have to come up with something by myself, but I love your suggestions. That's why I'm asking. But isn't that pretty? I love it. I think it turned out really cool. Once upon a time. And I don't know what I'm going to put in here, but it'll be something cool. Yeah. And you see that it's coming apart on the edge here. I might have to restable it or get a hammer. Yeah, but I'll probably paint this part in gold. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Well, thank you guys so much for joining me. And I will try to think of a project for us to do next time. I'm sure I'll come up with something. I have lots of stuff. I don't know. Maybe we can do an art journal page or a canvas. I love canvases, but you guys probably get sick of seeing canvases. So I'll try to think of something fun. You know what I could do is Eileen McGinnis, she made these really cool little puzzles out of cardboard because I watched her video today because I was able to watch videos. So I might do those. Maybe I'll do those next time. Okay, well, I'm going to let you guys go, I promise. And it's like kind of like a, you can use them in fun ways. So I might have to do that. We'll see. I don't know. Okay. Alrighty, guys. Thank you so much for joining me. It was such a joy. And I'm sorry I didn't get to interact with you guys as much as I would have liked to, but I still had a wonderful time. So you guys are awesome. And I'm going to say goodbye to you now. And I hope that you have a fabulous weekend. And you guys rock. You are so awesome. Alrighty, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye, guys. Bye-bye.